You like me when I made a fool of myself?
No. No, you just listened up for a minute. It's much more attractive than this image you put out for everyone. It lets people get close to you. I'd rather be with you when you're just being Sandy and not Mendenhall.
It's hard to just be Sandy.
I know.
But it's easy when I'm with you.
Hi, Colorado. I'm Fred Gandel, and we got baseball coming your way. The Memphis Blues and the new-look Sandy Mendenhall Denver Devils. And I'll tell you, Colorado, I think you're going to like this team. It's got more than a new owner. It's got a new pitching staff, a new front office, baseline ball girls, new uniforms, and it's got the deviled eggs. Fort Lauderdale Stadium in southern Florida, where the weather is absolutely perfect, beautiful blue skies, temperature 85 degrees, and not a cloud in the sky. There'll be 7,000 avid fans here to fill this ballpark here in Fort Lauderdale to watch two bitter rivals, the Denver Devils, formerly out of Washington, D.C., going up against the Memphis Blues, and they're formerly out of Baltimore. Last year, the last place Devils were 69-93, which put a little pressure on their manager, Dirk Miller, and the fourth place Blues were 80-82, just a couple of games under 500. There'll be two outstanding pitchers going today, Alvin Wall Street Chandler for the Devils, and for the Blues, it'll be Chico Brushback Carrasco. Last year, Carrasco went 15-9. He struck out 142 in 231 innings, and that Brushback is for real. He'll go after you. He'll go at you. He'll do anything to win a ball game. He'll be opposed by Alvin Wall Street Chandler. Last year, with a record of 11-13 and at 210 innings, was not a big strikeout pitcher, but only walked 75. So Chandler and Carrasco in the first spring exhibition game of this year, right here in Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
Second base is four. Shortstop is six. Third base is five. Okay, you got that?
Yeah.
Now beat it back to me.
All right, here we go, here we go. Okay, come on, Devil!
Excuse me,
number three.
Where's Mr. Miller?
Number five.
He's right over there, into the dugout.
No,
we're going to be here for a while.
He was the one.
You want a hot dog?
Oh, please. Everything except relish.
I'll be right back.
It's really very easy.
I hope I don't let you down.
I beg your pardon?
Oh, I was talking to myself.
Right-hand hitter, close stance, holds the bat on the end. The sign is out, and here's Chandler, the first pitch of the year on the way, and hit sharply by Cut. Great play!
All right, great
job.
What happened, honey?
I don't know.
Oh, Christ, you're supposed to be keeping score.
I'm sorry.
A lot
lot of good that does me.
Well, Collins lined to the shortstop and he made a diving catch.
Oh, thanks. You know, when I think your head's back in the game, I'll turn this thing off.
Carrasco
on the mound for the Blues, and one down. He gets a second out, and that sends up the shortstop, Jerry Washburn. Washburn waiting for the pitch by Carrasco. Here it comes. Oh, he almost got him. A fastball right in his head, and down he goes. Carrasco, we know now why they call a brushback. Washburn looking at Carrasco. They're staring each other down. No love lost between these two men. Washburn steps in again. Man, oh, man, it's only right down. Winds, deals, and he struck him out. Blazing fastball. Got in there. Both pitchers appear to be in midseason form. Wall Street Chandler and Brushback Carrasco both spent the winter in Puerto Rico where they pitched winter ball. And they are in high gear right now. And so as we move to the fourth inning, no score in the ball game, and neither team with a base hit.
Did you see that? Gary looked right at you.
He said, "My God."
Yes, he did, Calvin. Gary was admiring you, honey.
Carrasco's got a great screwball.
So what else is new?
It's going to make his fastball that much harder to hit.
Hey, you sound like you're rooting for the Blues.
Oh, no, I'm a Devil fan.
Well, Brushback's human. Someone's going to get to him.
Yeah.
Biggert, the batter, swings and hits a deep drive to straightaway center field. Barry off to a late start, heading for the wall, crashes into the wall, protected the ball. A spectacular play by Calvin Barry, but he's down in straightaway center field. The trainer on his way out there for the Denver Devils. It's Dick Dent checking him out. And Calvin Barry, let's see whether or not he stays in the ball game. He really hit the wall. He held on to the ball. It appears as though they're going to walk him in, and he may not.
In the game, Barry.
Well, thanks, Mr. Mendenhall. I got lucky.
A play like that deserves a reward. What's your favorite kind of champagne?
Cold duck?
Guess he's still shaking up. What are you doing here?
I'm going to get a drink of water.
Water?
Yeah.
In the middle of a close game?
Yeah. It's an old superstition.
Hey, uniform you want is ready, Dirk.
Thanks, Mike.
And I gave your note to
thanks,
the TA's
Mike. Goodbye,
amount,
Mike.
Sir.
Crazy, huh? This grown-up man with superstitions.
Yeah. Pretty weird, all right.
Yeah. I'm gonna go to the dugout now. I guess you're going with me, huh?
That's right. Any objections, Little?
No. It's your ball club, your dugout.
Chandler has run the count 3-1 to Walter Hearn, leading off the seventh inning. Gets a sign from Bresky. Chandler into the windup. The pitch to Hearn. High. Ball four, and down to first base goes Hearn. So the Blues put a man on with nobody out in the seventh inning.
Seventh inning. Why hasn't he scratched?
He will. Relax.
Oh, boy.
Do you want me to go see what's going on?
Would you? That'd be great.
Take it easy.
Norman Dowell, the batter, runner at first base, nobody out, seventh inning, no score on the ball game. Here's Chandler at the set, the kick and the pitch, bunted on the first base side. Bresky grabs it, over to first in time. Runner moves into scoring position at second.
No, I'm really worried. It's the seventh inning and Dirk's ignoring me completely.
Mendenhall is in the dugout.
Yeah.
I just saw him. Look, as long as he's there, Dirk is not going to go through with the plan. He's scared stiff of Mendenhall.
All right, take me to the clubhouse. I've got an idea. Excuse me, would you be a dear and make sure that nobody has time to play martini?
Cleanup batter Brian Bergeson coming up for the Memphis Blues with Walter Hearn at second base. One down, no score, top of the seventh inning. Alvin Wall Street Chandler in a jam for the first time of the ball game as Hearn leads off second. Waiting at the plate, Bergeson. Here's Chandler at the set. The kick and the pitch, and Bergeson rips it hard into right center field. Here's Walter Hearn rounding third. Gagliano and right fielder rifles it to the plate, and Hearn scores. Memphis leads 1-0.
What the hell are you doing out here?
Well, you might be rattled because you lost your shutout.
Hey, I'm as cool as Kool-Aid.
Okay. Good boy.
Keep a low and inside on this guy.
I got him! I got him! I got him!
He did it! He scratched! Wish me luck.
All right. Good luck.
That girl was not dealt a full deck, honey.
Looks like your cute little client kind of fell on a cute little face the other day, wouldn't you say?
How'd you like to get knocked on your cute little ass?
Goff tells me you've got some really big news.
That's right. Braves called. They've offered Leon the exact amount we wanted from you.
I don't believe it.
Well, I guess I'll just have to call them back and consummate the deal.
Hey, don't let him bluff you. I'm your center fielder.
I think we better talk about this outside.
Mm-hmm. Look, if you don't believe me, call Charlie Fox.
All right, I will call Charlie.
Okay.
I mean, Leon's good, but he's not that good.
Dirk, coast is clear.
Well, you're an over-anxious little thing, aren't you?
That jerk over there won't tell me where Mr. Ross is.
Oh, he won't, huh? Mike? Mike? Where's the uniform Dirk told you to get?
Hold your water. Oh, I got it right here.
Where do I dress?
Well, not out here.
Right in there.
Mike and Neil, stand guard.
Yes, I'd like to talk to Mr. Fox. No, I didn't say that. I said Fox, like the animal. F-O-X. This is why the Braves are always struggling. Yes, Fox. He's your general manager, idiot.
Well, how do I look?
Like a fool? I think she looks swell. Now get a hold of a bat and start warming up. I'm going back to the stand so I can watch.
Thanks, Mr. Goff.
Good luck.
What are you doing? You putting on some kind of a show after the game?
Yeah, it's called the screw-up hour.
Well, do you know where he is? Mr. Fox, F-O... Right. My name... Forget it. Whew, I'm exhausted.
Don't worry. We'll get it all straightened out.
Do you mind if I turn the radio on?
Mm-mm. Last half of the seventh inning, Ezric.
Oh, actually, I do mind.
Why, it's just a game.
Oh, I thought you were listening to a music station.
I hate that stuff. Here.
It's nicer for necking.
I think we better try it out. You're a nice girl. It's really too bad.
Was that screwball Carrasco struck you out on? It looked like a curve.
Look, this isn't your game. It's different out there.
I know.
Look, everything's faster out there. And meaner. And louder.
I think he'll try to set me up with off-speed pitches.
Look, it's not too late. You can still keep from making a fool of yourself. You can still back out. Look, because I know a ball player when I see one, and Sugar, you're just not it. You're quick for a girl, but you're not in our league. You know it, deep down. So be honest with yourself.
Why don't you shut up?
Carrasco on the mound for the Blues, checking out his catcher Dahl. The batter, Ezra Catton. The pitch on the way to Catton hit high and fairly deep to left field. Frederick backing up near the warning track, grabs it for the out. Two down, last of the seventh. Number 14.
Come on, you can hit this ball. An American!
Chico Carrasco checking out the hitter, Jose Padilla. He gets a sigh from his catcher. The right-hander winds, and the pitch on the way to Padilla. Hit hard! Left center field across Cookie Alley. Up the wall and left center.
And
there goes Padilla, racing into second base. It's a stand-up double.
I want a timeout. The wall is out in the groove.
Somebody's gloves he's wearing. I want a timeout. Tally up.
Go, you're up. There's 2 outs.
I can't.
Come on.
She's not quick enough.
What?
He's right, Mr. Miller. I don't think I can hit major league pitching.
I see.
Not quick enough.
She knows it, too. Hey!
Thanks, Mr. Miller.
Doesn't mean anything.
Not quick enough.
Hey, this is off a helmet.
Hey, Dirk! What the hell's going on here?
Slight delay. I'm sorry.
Get your man out there right now.
Hey, kid!
I said no more time back here.
Get in a new hitter, okay? William Mazzino, come here!
I'm hitting for you, baby.
What do you mean?
I'm sorry, Sidney. I'm sorry. It had to happen.
Sooner I can do the job.
It had to happen. I'm sorry. Sit down.
Okay. Have your attention, please. Now batting for Denver, number 11, the first woman to play in a Major League Baseball game.
Sounds like a World Series crowd.
Wait a minute. What is going on here?
Relax. It's an exhibition game.
Relax. Hell, I've been lied to. Miller said no non-roster players. All right, I'll sit down.
We'll all sit down. Come on, you guys. This game is over. Chico, make it. Up and down.
Yeah!
on that before you came in.
Thank you.
say that I have had Paul in the works for quite some time now. As you might expect, Miss West and I have a lot to talk about.
Well,